across the world, from the Indo-Pacific to Africa to Latin America, we see inspiring stories of extraordinary innovation changing ordinary lives. But there is much to be done. Our focus should be Sarvodaya, development of all, through Antyodaya, that is, development of the most marginalized. We must bring the unbanked 1.7 billion people in the world into the formal financial market. We must extend the security of insurance and pension to more than 1 billion workers in the informal sectors worldwide who still do not have it. We can use fintech to ensure that no dream remains unfulfilled and no enterprise remains stillborn because of lack of access to finance. We must make banks and financial institutions more resilient in managing risks, fighting frauds, and dealing with disruption of traditional models. We have to use technology to improve compliance, regulation and supervision, so that innovation flourishes and risks are contained. We must use fintech tools to combat money laundering and other financial crimes. The emerging world of finance will succeed in our interconnected world when our data and system are trusted and secure. We have to make our globally wired system safe from cyber threats. We must also ensure that the space and the push of fintech work to the advantage of the people, not to their disadvantage, that technology in finance ensures improvement of the human condition through direct contact with the most marginalized. We also need to enhance awareness of the masses and educate them about the opportunities which inclusive policies and use of technology open up for them. For this, fintech will need to be not merely a mechanism, but a movement. And we have to address the inevitable questions. The data ownership and flow, privacy and consent, private and public good, law and ethics. Finally, we must invest in creating skills for the future and be prepared to back ideas and invest for the long term.